Very anarchistic in our approach to our business and our company, and you know, we were the only record company for many years who never had contracts with its groups. We were the only company in Britain that didn't hype, which means by hype it means a particular form of retail operation, and we were that way for many years. We've now dropped many of those things, changed many of those things. We're now very different, we're very ruthless and the rest of it. But I don't know, one of the theories is that if you've been somewhere else, you can never be this. You can never be quite the same because of where we've come from. Because we've come from this, you know. Even though I say we're now ruthless and we don't mess about, the new Northside album does not have the second single on it, which, you know, is stupid. Our electronic album does not have the first single on it, and we're going to get blathered by imports from America and Europe because that does have the first single on it. And we do that because we're a factory, and if our musicians want to do something like that, we say yes. I think we take business very seriously. Maybe we always do, but maybe we were playing at it more in the early days. I think we take it more seriously. Certainly, having our groups under contract, something we never did, that was a major sea change for us. We just got tired of every time we built a group like James or the Railway Children or whatever, relevant to the fortunes of Factory Records. Blue Monday was not on the album, and therefore the sale of a million Blue Mondays and the success of that single didn't sell any albums. Power Corruption Lies did not contain the single. The artwork was so incredibly complex for the Blue Monday sleeve that we made only 4p profit on every single we sold of the million, and out of that 4p profit we had to pay 7p publishing royalties. So we lost 3p on every copy of Blue Monday sold. So it had absolutely no impact on the fortunes. It had a minus impact on the fortunes of Factory Records, I have to say. The record that made a difference to our fortunes was True Faith. Because True Faith was massively successful as a hit single, well, quite successful, and it sold lots of copies of Substance, the album that it was off. And really, True Faith and Substance were a major, you know, New Order doubled their market base throughout the world, and that was the most significant moment. And the prime group, the Happy Mondays, were already on the labels. That was a shock. We always have someone who kind of like is more responsible for A&R than anybody else. At the beginning it was me, and then it was Rob and New Order were kind of very A&R-ish. I think Rob brought in James, for example, in the early days. And then Mike Pickering, the DJ, was like doing A&R and the rest of it. And in that, so in that period, Mike would say, there's a group, mate of mine manages them, blah, blah. I think they're really good. Come and see them. We put them on at the house. You just go along and you watch for 2 minutes and you go, yeah. Or no, depending on what you're going. You know, you watch the Mondays and you go, yeah, great, they're it. Hey, Rainmaker, come out, wait from that man. You know he's gonna take away your promised land. Hey, good lady, he just want what you got. You know he'll never stop until he's taken the lot. Fire can change your desire. Northside, I kind of got three phone calls one afternoon. One from my now head of A&R, Phil Sachs, one from Nathan, the Mondays manager, and then one from Phil Sachs again to say that Derek Ryder, Sean and Paul Ryder's dad, had rung him. And all three of these phone calls were about Northside. And although I went to see them the next week, those three phone calls were such, I didn't even need to see them. Person. On this one question, I am unbearable, really. I've never been wrong. I think atmosphere is my favourite. I would say that it's been worth it, the whole thing, just to be the person who signed the checks that paid for the labels that went on that single. Just to be in any way involved with a piece of music like that, I find still quite, I'm quite surprised that I've been lucky enough to be in some way involved with a piece of music like Atmosphere.